Hello students, in previous video we start the unit 2nd and unit 2nd is based on the tailed falls. In that, in your syllabus, first group is the Lepidophyta. In Lepidophyta we will discuss about the genus Lycopodium. In previous video I already told about Lycopodium classifications and external morphology. So third point is the anatomy of roots of Lycopodia. So in that, first of all you have to write down about the introductory part, that is the Lycopodium is pteridophyte, then it is vascular cryptogam, that means they develop the vascular elements like xylems and phloem. Then it has two distinct generation, that is sporophytic and gametophytic generation. In these Lycopodium, the sporophytic generation is dominant, which is diploid and independent. The second is the gametophytic generation. Gametophytic generation is in recessive stage and it is haploid and dependent. Then about the external morphology, as you already discussed, the sporophytes of Lycopodium having three distinct parts, root, stem and leaves. The roots of these Lycopodium plants are adventitious roots, and they are dichotomously branched. They are endogenously originated, and mostly they are originated from the lower sides of the prostrate stem. So with this background we will start about the anatomy of the roots. So this is the transverse sections of roots of the Lycopodium. You've seen the figure. This is the outline of the transverse sections of root line. In that, the outer layer is the epidermis. On that epidermis, the root hairs are there. This epidermis followed by the sclerenchymatous outer cortex. Then, next to the sclerenchymatous, next to the cortex layer, there is the inner cortex. This inner cortex is made by the parenchymatous cells, and at the center stele is there. In this stele, the xylems and phloems are there. So with this figure we will discuss the actual transverse sections of these roots of the Lycopodium. The transverse sections of this root is distinguished into three parts: epidermis, cortex and stele. So first we will start the epidermis. So epidermis, it is the outermost layer. It is made by the single layer and it is thin walled cells. That's why it is called as the uniseriate. And on that layer, or on that epidermis, the root hairs are present. Then next part of this transverse section or inner sides to the epidermis, the cortex region is there. This cortex region is divided into two parts, outer cortex and inner cortex. The outer cortex is, which is present next to the epidermis, it made by the many layers of the sclerenchymatous cells. Then inner cortex is the next to the outer cortex. It is also made by the many layers, and the in that layer the parenchymatous cells are there. So this is the cortex region. Then the cortex region is followed by the stele. So stele is nothing but the central core part of the plant axis. In that, or it is the central core of the root axis. So in that stele, the vascular elements are there like xylems and phloem. In that, endodermis and pericycles are absent. So stele is diarch, tetrarch or polyarch, depending upon the species, the conditions will be observed. So in the diarch stele, mostly the crescent shaped xylem or exarch xylem conditions will be observed.
and also the phloem present in the center and xylem in the crescent shape. In that region the pith is absent. So the exact condition or the crescent shaped xylem, crescent shape, that means the you have to see in this figure. Crescent shape, that means the middle portion are thick and tapering at the both the ends. यहाँ पे हमें हाफ मून की तरह स्ट्रक्चर दिख रहा है. तो जो मिडल पोर्शन इज समॉट थिक एंड एट द बोथ साइड हैविंग द टैपरिंग एंड्स. सो द शेप इज द क्रिसेंट शेप एंड एग्जैक्ट कंडीशन, दैट मीन्स यू हैव टू सीन द फिगर. एट द इनर साइड द प्रोटोजाइलम्स आर देयर एंड मेटाजाइलम्स एट द आउटर साइड. तो प्रोटोजाइलम इज द फर्स्ट स्टेज ऑफ द xylem or metaxylem is the second stage. So development is from inner sides to the outer sides, that means protoxylem to the metaxylem. So the development, it is from central to the outside, that's why the term used as a exarch conditions. I hope all of you got this point. So this is the characters of dictyostele in that or sorry not dictyostele it is the diastele. So in that crescent shaped xylem and exarch conditions, and the phloem is also at the centers of this xylem. So this is the anatomical parts of the root of the Lycopodium. In that main character is the pith is absent, crescent shaped xylem, exarch conditions, and endodermis and pericycles are absent. So this is about the transverse sections of the Lycopodium roots. In that the sections will be differentiated into three parts: outer epidermis, then cortex, which is again divided into two parts, inner outer cortex and inner cortex, and the central part is the stele.